Was coming up with a spray can and a lighter. Like right. He was about to do something.
Is he the one who lit the flag?
I think he may have been from the comments that I heard.
Did he have a mask with the skull?
To be honest with you, I don't recall. But a bunch of people were trying to kind of back him off. So trying to, you know, get a couple shots, get some footage. And then all of a sudden somebody got angry, got up in my face. I didn't say anything. Next thing I know, I'm surrounded by a bunch of people. Something about, oh, you're with the police. So I didn't really say anything. I just kind of, you know, I stood there. And next thing I know, I've got a bunch of people, you know, a couple people swinging and, you know, stuff like that. So
did you get hit?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I've got a chipped tooth.
You've got a chip.
Oh, yeah, I can feel it. Yeah.
And, sir, before you got hit, I actually saw a couple of protesters were trying to put some water on your camera.
Yeah.
And I saw the gentleman connect with, I believe it was a riot. And how are you feeling right now?
Well, I've been through worse. I mean, you know.
What do you think
of been through worse?
I'm hard pressed to think of an example, but I mean, my point being that, you know,
sir, what do you think about these protesters attacking press? Yesterday, Daily Caller, a female reporter, a female reporter with the Daily Caller actually got assaulted yesterday. And the situation with you today, do you think this is a safe place for journalists and reporters to come?
Well, it's becoming unsafe. Two nights ago, on Sunday night? I was down here with a group and I walked with them. We marched about 5 miles. We went out to McConnell's, DC house, a few stops on the way. That was all very calm and, uneventful other than, the events in and of themselves. But I don't know, this is a drastically different scenario at this point.